This can't be.
Thank you.
I guess I never got a chance to look around this place.
Hello? Is anyone there?
Jeremy, where are you?
I'm stuck in the mud and the fire is taking me.
Jeremy? Can you hear me?
The motor is dead. I can't do anything more.
Hang on, Jeremy. I'll get the boat running. I'll get you out of here. The boat has run aground, crashed right into the bayou. If I get the motor running, I could try backing into the river.
Thank you.
The winch seems to be powered by electricity. Maybe I can find a way to turn it on. Break this. I just need something to hit it with. Just needs fuel to run. Jeremy?
Are you ready to tell me?
What's happening?
I've got a rope around my neck, and then I strangled all life from my body.
Uncle!
Are you under the impression that you died? Yes. No. I was supposed to die. What does that mean to you? That you were supposed to die?
I'm the catalyst. I had to die to make the story happen.
Story? What are you referring to, Jeremy?
30 years ago, Frederic needed me to die.
Jeremy!
You're not making any sense. Come back. Find your focus.
Uncle?
I cheated everyone. I didn't play my part. I escaped my doom. Destiny!
Again. Find your focus.
Jeremy!
Now everything is wrong. Nothing is in place.
Hey, listen to me. We're gonna drown.
Calm down, Miss Hartwood. You're not in any danger.
But Jeremy, he was here, wasn't he?
Miss Hartwood, I am beginning to suspect your family curse is catching up with you. Have you ever talked to a doctor about your condition?
No. No, I was just confused. I thought I saw him for a moment. I'm fine. I'll let you be.
Miss, I want you to know I'm here to help, if you need me.
Miss Hartwood, lock the door, will you? I'd rather not run into dear Dr. Gray if I can help it.
This feels strange, so very strange. There's a book missing.
You okay?
This place? It's like something from my childhood.
It's just a private study of a very peculiar man.
Ah, what's this?
Secret door.
Looks like it.
Careful. Let me go first. Now we're talking. Great job, Emily.
Good to finally meet you, Mr. Hartwood. I'm here on the behalf of your brother, Philip. You were expecting me, weren't you?
Yes. You're from DeSoto, no?
That's right. I just wanted to ask you a few questions to see if there is anything I can do to help you and your family.
Okay.
I understand you're full of imagination. You make up a lot of things.
I suppose.
And you obsess over them, blurring reality and fiction.
Sometimes.
Do you want to tell me about the Dark Man?
No. No, I don't.
That's all right. Perhaps there is something else you can tell me. Something you know to be made up, but you hold dear.
Juan?
John? Who's John?
No, Juan Luis Jorge. Ooh, wait there a moment. Here, take a look.
Is he... Oh, he is the author.
Found anything?
Oh, Dr. Gray's in so deep, I knew it. He's as mad as his patients. I mean, look at this. She who can till the soil of this sick world and begin again. The black goat of the woods with 1,000 young. Absolute insanity.
Should I even be doing this? Do I want to know? Jesus Christ, why would you paint this, Jeremy? What on earth possessed you? Oh, God. I can't believe I didn't see that before. Hello? Who's there? Jeremy?
Jeremy is with the Dark Man. You can't save him.
Jeremy is with the Dark Man? Where? Who is he? What is the Dark Man?
The Hartwood Curse. He will come for you too.
You heard the telephone ring, right?
No, the telephone's cut off. I tried calling the police earlier.
Yeah, that's what I figured. Hey, Mr. Carnby?
What?
Nothing, right?
It's a closet.
That's right, Detective. I'll see you later. I have to finish this.
You're going inside the closet?
I know what it looks like, but I can't explain it, much less justify it.
All right. You do what you have to do, miss.
Goodbye, Detective.